10 Big Brother stars have had just 2 weeks to learn and perfect their skills for the pantomime performance today. Now, you, the audience at home, and our gang in the audience here, we're going to see very, very shortly whether 2 weeks of all that commitment, learning lines, is going to pay off or not. There's a few people in the audience that you might recognise. Tell you what, I'm here with John Tickle. John, who are you looking... I'm very well, thanks. Who are you looking forward to seeing today?
Well, I'm looking forward to seeing Tim in his high heels. That should be quite a laugh.
Right, because he's one of the ugly sisters.
Oh, yes, yeah.
And you think he's going to be good?
Oh, those two have put some real work in. I'm looking forward to seeing them.
Good stuff. Thank you very much, John. These are my two mates. So you could have made some effort, boys. Would have been all right. How you doing? You all right?
Yes, thank you very much.
You are Spencer's mum, aren't you?
Well, so they told me at the hospital, yeah.
So they told you. Are you looking forward to seeing him dressing up as a woman?
Yes.
Does he usually parade around in women's clothes?
Not that I know of, no.
Not usually. But do you know what? I've seen it in rehearsal and I've seen the smile on his face. I think he really gets something out of it. If he does start wearing lipstick, things like that, he could be Nadia's new friend.
Do you reckon?
Or the new Nadia. Would you be happy about that?
Ask me later.
Oh, I will ask you later. Moving on. Got Kitten's girlfriend Leandra, how are you?
Hi, good, thank you.
You're all right? How do you think Kitten's going to get on tonight?
Well, she can't sing or act or dance, and she doesn't seem to have been doing much practicing, so
she'll
be brilliant.
You're really confident about it
yeah,
for it.
Yeah, really confident, she'll be fantastic.
You haven't seen her for a little while, so you're going to have a lot of love to show her afterwards?
Yeah, I think so.
Always. I remember that kiss on Big Brother. Yeah, woo! We're here with Victor's friend now, Obi, how you getting on?
I'm all right, how are you?
Right, you've got an haircut that matches your jumper. Is this something that Victor might be sporting next time we see him?
Maybe. I've tried to get him to do it for years, but it's just my thing, but he just doesn't want to
do it. He's just not that outgoing as you. Right, how do you feel about him? Because he turned down getting dressed up as a woman, didn't he?
Yeah.
But he was really, like, in fact about it. He was not up for it. Have you ever seen him wearing any high heels or anything like that?
No, that's just not, a thing he does, man.
Maybe he might do it. I recognise you two. These are Jade's friends. I'll tell you what, let's sit down and watch the pantomime. Viewers at home, everybody, Cinderella!
I'm a big fairy. Come down from afar with cunning stunts aplenty for your delectation today. Join me, be extra gay! Our tale today is of rags, two witches, of a lowly servant girl and a white pair of bitches. You should hear him singing. On my word, they're minging! And the smell of them is pure kipper. And what else is in this tale? A glass slipper! And away in yonder castle there's a bloke who doesn't mince, though he's met plenty of queens. For you see, he's a prince! And you should see the size of his ball. He's only got the one, but it isn't small. And so, our tale is set. I hope your whistle is well and truly wet. And while I bring myself off with my umbrella, sit back, relax, and enjoy the tale of Cinderella!
Dear one in the magic faraway land of East Anglia, kitchen at Heart of Hall, and Cinderella's pussy is working up a sweat.
Hey, what's cracking, boys and girls? They call me Buttons. Oh, come on, you can do better than that. Anyone think you've ever seen a talking pussycat before? Now, when I say, what's cracking, boys and girls, I want you guys to reply, what's cracking, Buttons? What's cracking, boys and girls?
What's cracking, Buttons?
That's better. Now, I know it's not every day you see a jungle cat doing the housework. But you see, I'm here trying to scoop my number one girl in a bag of pearls. Her name's Cinderella. Where the street is, she's the most hectic girl you've ever seen with your own two eyes. If only I had the testicular fortitude to show her how much I love her. But then she wouldn't look twice at an old moggy like me. And if she did, she'd probably get arrested.
Hi, Buttons. Talking to you, Sam.
No, Cinders. I'm talking to the boys and girls out there.
But it's so hard for me to stay, Buttons. I've been crying all day long. Oh, Buttons, I'm so unhappy.
Oh, come on, guys. She's more unhappy than that. Come on. Oh, she's not that unhappy, guys. Oh, come now, Cinders. How many times must I tell you? Don't feel down. Celebrity Big Brother starts tomorrow.
But my family is so horrible to me. They only let me watch Heartbeat and Family Affair.
Bloody hell, love, they're worse than I thought.
Hey, Buttons, I found another one of those weird notes again.
What does he say this time?
Your mum's toast. But how can your mum be a piece of burnt bread? And strangely enough, he looks somewhat like Papa's handwriting. Oh no, they're going to be up any minute now, and I still haven't been down to the shop to get the food for breakfast. Buttons, I better get my skates on.
Dare I tell her how I feel about her?
Yes!
Should I tell her?
Yes!
Dare I tell her?
Yes!
What do you boys and girls think I should do?
Tell her!
Hey, Cinders, would you ever marry a ginger jungle cat?
If he weren't a minger, then I could do a ginger.
Oh. What if he was really hairy?
Love is blind, Buttons.
What if he could cough up fur balls willy-nilly like...
Oh, Cinderella!
Oh, no, there are!
Oh, bollocks!
Where's my breakfast, bitch?
Yes, Cinders, I'm hungry, comprende?
She needs a lot of breakfast to keep her fat ass so huge.
And how do you keep your gob so big?
You cheeky cat!
Cinders, pick me up this instant.
Come in, Josie, come in.
Jordan and Jodie, Cinderella's pig ugly sisters.
I had this filthy dream last night. Oh, it was rotten. I dreamt I was stuck in this rugby scrum with nothing on but a bottle of baby oil. I wake up all covered in sweat. At least I think it was sweat.
Well, I had a nightmare. I dreamt I was falling out of a club and I was wearing clothes.
You'd soon know if you were wearing no clothes in public, girl.
Why, because I'd be freezing.
No, you'd be covered in puke. You make me want to heave.
Bollocks!